bad news for you. Look at what you're watching. It's EETV, and surprise, it's live from here in East Elgin. That's right, go Eagles! Let's see what's up at our school. But only for a couple minutes, and then you gotta get back to well.
Good morning, Eagles. Today is Wednesday, June 21st. It's the final day of our school year. I'm Lucas Van Troost. You guys, come here. Thank you.
You're squishing me.
Oh, that's all right.
Everyone all at once. And here, who wants to go first?
Want to earn all your community hours in 1 week this summer? The tech department at East Elgin is hosting a summer tech camp for elementary school students during the second week of summer. See guidance for more details.
Reminder, all students, please clean out your lockers and remove your locks and take everything out by 3 p.m. Return textbooks to your appropriate teachers, and thanks for helping keep our school clean. Now let's head over to our VP, Ms. Cochran.
All right, thanks, Yuki. And thanks to the EETV team for all they've done this year. The admin team would also like to wish everyone a happy last day of classes. And please remember to clear out your locker today and take your lock by the end of the day. A few reminders about exam assessment days starting tomorrow. All students need to be present unless you've spoken to your teachers and admin team prior. You need to write your exam assessment at a scheduled time unless your teacher has provided another time slot. Students in grade 11 and 12 writing exams will need to stay for at least 1 hour. And also, I know it can be a long day, but buses are running at regular times and you can get picked up early. Once your exam and assessment is finished, you need to stay out of the hallways. The cafeteria will be open all day, and the library will be open after lunch. So best of luck starting tomorrow. Have a great day.
And attention all EDUCAST participants, pick up your, attention all EDUCAST participants, please pick up your EDUCAST t-shirts if you haven't already done so from the co-op office ASAP.
An important announcement from guidance. There will be no course changes until September. Please see the school website in September for the link to request a course change.
This year's yearbook is on sale now, and if you have no idea how to order it, then watch this video.
That's why I'd be... Oh, wrong part.
Hey Eagles, Lucas.
And Ian here.
And obviously, you already know, we're making a yearbook this year. It may be because I whined and begged for quotes for, 3 months.
Yep, and you may be wondering how you can get your hands on one.
Well, it's super simple.
Ow!
And all you have to do is type ybpay.ca into your preferred search browser.
That's ybpay.ca. And then once you hit the enter key, you're in the website.
Because that's how websites work.
Once you enter the website, you're going to see a big LifeTouch logo. You don't want that. Go down. Then you're going to see a box that has yearbook ID codes in it. You don't want that. Go down. Go down again. There you go.
Now that you're on this page, you'll see a giant LifeTouch. You still don't want that. Move down to the first box. Now you have to select your province. Boop. And now select your town, city, hamlet, or whatever else. Boop. Now search. Perfect.
At the top of this page, you're gonna see a blue LifeTouch logo. Still, do not touch that. Go down. Then you're gonna see your school's yearbook code. You did it. Now hit select. Good job. Now fill in your student information. Hit next. Now you're gonna select how many yearbook copies you want. Now, give us your credit card information. And hit next.
Once you're on the next page, there will be no more big Life Touch button. Congrats, you didn't click it. Now that you're on this page, give us all of your billing information. And I mean all of it, including your credit card number, your bank statements, everything. Anyways, once you've done that, and now just click continue to payment, and you're set.
So let's sell some product, Eagles.
Yearbooks on sale now. YBPay.ca. Ow!
Cool.
That's YBPay.ca.
Any of misdemeanor students from last semester or last year have left their art in the art room. Can you please pick it up to take home, please? Otherwise, it will be thrown out at the end of the school year. Terrible shame. We love art. Don't make us throw it out. Pick up your art, please.
Hi, dance club members. This is a reminder of our year-end party lunch today in the dance studio. Come on down for some music, snacks, moving, and goodbyes as we head into summer.
For any senior boys interested in senior volleyball next year, please come to a very brief meeting at the beginning of lunch in Mrs. Hanley's room, room 319.
Welcome to Wellness Wednesday. Remember, as we move into the final days of the semester, to take care of your mental and emotional health. Feeling some stress is natural at this point of the year. No kidding. But make sure you have a plan to deal with those stressful feelings in a healthy way.
Get up for a walk, try some meditation, or relax with friends. These small actions can do wonders for your overall well-being. Please follow along with this one-minute stretch break to get you right for the day.
I gotta stretch.
Hello, my name is Tierra, and welcome to your one-minute stretch with McGill Athletics and Recreation. We'll start by standing up and placing both hands behind the head. Fingers are interlaced. Elbows are slightly forward. Press the back of the head in towards your hands, dropping the chin in towards your neck. Ribs and chest are nice and soft as you breathe. You're welcome to close down the eyes. Start by breathing in through the nose and exhaling out through the mouth. Two more big deep breaths. And open up the gaze. Bring your palms back towards your sides, checking out your nice tall stance. And thank you for joining us for the one-minute stretch break. Have a wonderful day.
All right, Sumner, Mr. Arnett has kindly put together a GABA highlight video showing some great moments in Eagle Athletics throughout the year. And we thought it would be a great time to share with all of you.
talk dirty to me.
You know the words in my songs. No, habla English.
Girl, set you hallelujah. Girl, set you hallelujah.
Our conversations ain't long, but you know what is.
Girl, set you hallelujah. Cause I'm tough.
Elgin Spec Ed Department, along with their best buddies, participated in two track meets over the last few weeks. And Weekend Weather's own Aaron Brown, here he is, created this highlight video for your enjoyment.
Thank you.
Amazing video. And now it is time for your summer version of weekend weather.
Yay. Here we go again. Okay.
Hello, Eagles. This is Yuki here. We're here with the rest of the weekend weather crew. And the Weather Network is predicting a come-and-go type of season across Canada this summer.
So be prepared for periods of hot and dry weather, cut by bursts of cooler temperature.
This is Yuki, signing off.
Bye, everyone. I love you. Bye. So long, y'all.
Bye.
Bye.
Give way.
I'm Aaron, and I'm signing off.
And that's all that we have for you today, Eagles.
Jai von Luta.
Ciao. Have a great summer.
Today, the first day of summer, we recognize June 21st as National Indigenous Peoples Day. And it's a day to celebrate and honor Indigenous heritage, diversity, and cultures, as well as the outstanding achievements of First Nations, Inuit, and Métis people throughout Canada. Since time immemorial, June 21st, or the summer solstice, has been celebrated and honored Indigenous communities as the longest day of the year. In 1996, while working with Indigenous communities, the Government of Canada officially recognized June 21st as National Indigenous Peoples Day.
Over the course of the year, the First Nations, Métis, and Inuit students at East Elgin have been working with Indigenous artist Mike Sywink, love you to death, to add FNMI representation to our school. We invite you to watch the following video, which explains the mural they created.
Bonjour, everybody. Nimkigis is Indigenous cause, Ajijak and Dotem. I just introduced myself in our original language. My spirit name is Thunder Day, and I am Crane Clan. I'm Anishinaabeg from Manitoulin Island area, and from my father's from Chippewa of the Thames. I work full-time at Western University and am a part-time artist. So I felt very honored to come here and work with the FNMI students on our mural project. All the ideas and the ideology behind the image came from the students, and I just kind of helped put it together and kind of guide the ship in terms of what we were going to create and kind of the story we wanted to tell. With all my artwork, it's all about storytelling and telling a story. So with this piece, that's exactly what we tried to do. We tried to inject some Indigenous culture here into East Elgin. So I'll kind of go through the image and kind of describe what the meanings are and kind of what we were thinking when we were creating this piece. So starting from the right side, we have a figure holding a hand drum standing on the back of a turtle shell. That's representative of culture. Singing and drumming are a big part of Indigenous ceremony, Indigenous culture. And as you can see, there's some purple and pink kind of going through the rest of the piece. And that was our message and our way of trying to inject some FNMI culture here into East Elgin. Art is a great way to do that and to tell stories. So we wanted to show that within our story. So that's what that part of the whole piece represents. We call the area that we live in, we call it Turtle Island. So that's why our figure is standing on top of the back of the turtle shell. There's a lot of Indigenous issues out there that are pretty important to Indigenous communities and to our students. One of them is the missing and murdered Indigenous women pandemic that is happening. So that's why we put the figure in red. Also, we have an Inukshuk on the back of the turtle shell as well, and that represents kind of the diversity. Not every single Indigenous student, if you're labeled Indigenous, it's not just one culture and one set of teachings and language and stuff. There's so many different communities and nations. We wanted to show a little bit of that diversity. You could kind of see like the grayish buildings, kind of the buildings that are in the back of the center of the piece. And that kind of represents what I was told the East Elgin was like before in terms of like First Nation representation. There wasn't a whole lot here for our FNMI students. So it was great that we were able to take this project on and inject some culture here in the school. And it's absolutely a fantastic thing. And I'm so appreciative of the staff and the administration and everybody wanting to take a project on like this. Some of the other pieces and some of the other elements within the piece, we have the Northern Lights. A lot of the students talked about how outdoor recreation is such an important part of their upbringing and their ways of life. So that's what the fish represent, going fishing, spending the time outdoors. And that part is pretty important. So we also have the colors of the medicine wheel. The medicine wheel colors are, there are a ton of teachings that go along with the medicine wheel. For this one, we wanted to represent the community, the white, the yellow, the red, and the black. So we think about all the different types of students that go here, not just the Indigenous students, but all the ones from different communities and different backgrounds. That's what those colors represent. We also have the eagle. I believe it is the East Elgin Eagles. So we wanted to show that in there as well. And the respect that the eagle commands and deserves, especially from an Indigenous perspective, is something that we wanted to show and showcase within our piece. And as you kind of go around the corner, you can see the medicine wheel colors continuing on. That's representative of like our students continuing their journey. Like their stop here at East Elgin is only for a small portion of their lives, but an important part. And they're eventually going to go on and hopefully do great things and continue their journey, their learning journey, and making our world and our communities a better, safer place. As you go up the pillars, you can see different flowers and different representations. Again, you'll see like the medicine wheel colors. Also, instead of not just for a representation of people, but they also represent the four directions. So whatever direction our students go on afterwards, whether they go north, south, east, or west, or whichever way that they decide to go, to know that we're all supportive of them and want them to do great things. And a big part of my teachings and what I was taught was connection. So as you can see throughout the whole entire piece, everything's connected, right? They all flows together, and we think about our connection to land, our connection to water, our connection to spirit, all those different things, connection to ceremony. It's an important piece of who we are. We have to walk together with creation, right? We wouldn't be here without Mother Earth and Turtle Island providing everything that we could ever ask for in this life. So we have to walk together in partnership and in unison with creation. So that was it. We tried to represent the student community, the student body, and trying to inject some culture, some FNMI culture here into East Elgin. I feel very fortunate to be able to work with such an amazing group of students, and I hope you guys all enjoy it. Go have a look at it, tell us what you think, and again, very appreciative for these opportunities, so be glad for listening.
All right, home slice, bread slice, dog, we're going out to my top D, Mr. Dwyer. Woo!
Hello, my little egomaniacs, Mr. Dwyer here. The EETV broadcast season for 2023 is almost over. I know it's been a long one, folks, but anyways, I just wanted to say a big thank you to everybody who works at EETV. Let me hear that applause. You know, for a club, this is a special group of people. You know, usually for about 7 minutes out of your day, we get together and we give you some information that you need for your day. And you know what? We have a lot of fun doing it. So I also want to thank the audience for putting up with us, because sometimes we are wild and crazy. But anyways, yes. I would also like to thank the admin, because without their support, we wouldn't be here. It was touch and go for a while, and you know what? You're helping support and getting some key equipment together for this broadcast is much appreciated. So to the admin, hats off. Where's the applause? You got it? Okay, don't worry. Well, we got the applause here. I thought it was Ken, but no, we're live. This is live TV. Also, I'd like to thank teachers who add to the announcements. And, you know, I'm probably going to miss some people, but you know who I'm talking about. You know, Geezer, he brings so much here. And, you know, if you don't know who Mr. Geezer is, I'm not going to tell you. But anyways, he is awesome. Also, Mr. Edmonds, Miss Robbins, Mr. Arnett's awesome GABA video highlight reel. Where would we be without that spectacular stuff? We got the applause. Excellent. And Mr. Neubauer, he does these Wellness Wednesday videos, and I'll tell you, sometimes these things really help out for me. And I appreciate all that stuff. I also appreciate the students who aren't really necessarily considered part of EETV, but regularly come on here and do their part. Faith, Alexa, Mackenzie, the Shadow Council, all of you, I love you all, and I thank you for being part of this program. So give yourself a prize. Applause. You have it. Also, you know, there's a few teachers here who it's their last day of teaching, and I'm thinking about Mr. Black, Mr. Haida, Mr. Mater, and Mr. Voros. If you get a chance to see these people in the hallways, you might want to, like, congratulate them on a career well spent being a teacher. All right, so hats off to them, too. Awesome. I love that prize. That is wild. All right. Now, for EETV, we have 7 students who are graduating or moving on. And I will miss every one of them. We've got such a special group here. You know, when I think about it, this is the COVID gang. And they had 2 years wiped from their high school experience. But what did they do? They made the other 2 years count. And I salute you guys for that. Applause. Awesome. And we here at EETV put together a little farewell video for these people who are moving on. And yeah, just what you need, another video. Take it away, Maggie.
Dum, dee-dum, 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 dum-dum, dee-dum, 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 dee-dum. Goodbye, farewell, be on your merry way. We are going to miss you every single day. So long, adieu, ta-ta and toodaloo. On my merry way, I'll always think of you. On land, or sand, or gravel, or where the roads we travel unravel, it's more fun with two. It's always me and you, and together we will stay. Dum 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 dum. Through warm or stormy weather, we'll always be together forever. For within my heart, if we should ever part, we'll be never far away from each other. We'll be never far away. Dum dum dum.
This is Yuki. I'm cooking my coffee and I'm hanging out.
Bye, Yuki.
Let's go,
I'm Paige Collins and I guess I'm signing off. And Amy, I guess I won't see you tomorrow. Bye, Paige. I'll miss you. Bye, guys.
I am leaving and then I'm leaving.
That went pretty well.
That went really well, dude.
You don't need to get, like, stop hurting yourself.
This is Hayden King, and I guess I'm signing off. Bye, or something.
I'm Catherine Corliss, and I guess I'm signing off.
Wait, go next.
I'm Serena Bronze, my last year, last day. Love you guys.
And now we go outside to the podium for a quick announcement.
You get this.
Thank you for always tuning in, and it was a really fun experience. So it's enjoying coming here. And even though y'all are nerds,
okay, hang on. We're
start from the beginning, okay, John? Start from the beginning.
Am I good? I'm good? Okay. All right, Eagles, it's been really fun doing EETV for the past 2 years, even though Dora said we lost 2 years, but it's fine. We still had fun, and even though y'all are nerds, I guess I won't see you later.
I'm Lucas Van Truth. And breaking news for the last time of the year, hopefully, maybe, probably not, I swear it better be. I just wanted to say a massive, huge, big, massive, I said that already, thank you to everyone who helped this year with EETV and anything tech-wise. Our head of tech this year was Maggie Harkness, huge shout out, thank you, we love you so much. Thank you so much for our fearless leader for Tech AV and EETV, Mr. Dwyer. Thank you so much. Huge shout out. Love you. Also co-running yearbook with Mr. Green. Thank you, Mr. Green. and thank you guys for EETV. Whether you're on camera, off screen, doing all the technical parts of the show, or even if you wrote the EETV theme, because you know what, Ian? Honestly, it is super entertaining and super local. Above all, I thank you for being a friend to me and to others and your hardworking effort to fix any technical issues we may have had, and we've had a lot. Found it. As you can tell, I'm in grade 12, and I've been doing this for years. 4 years. Four very short years. And I'm leaving along with a few others. Paige, Josh, Serena, Maggie, anyone else I forgot, I'm super sorry. But I graduated, I know, big surprise. But I want to let you all know that it's now up to you and 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 you. And even you who's on your phone not paying attention because we played all those videos and learned nothing this year. That's right, I know you hear me. Listen up, listen close. It's up to you too, actually. It's up to you to make this school a better place. And what chance better than joining the EETV club? And you know what? In fact, did you know that there might be a whole class you can take next year for EETV? Yearbook, PSA ads, and other technical social media type projects. It's called communications, and it's really interesting. But that's a different time, story, thing. With that, I hand it off. Goodbye, Eagles. Won't you forget about me? You can come.